the biggest example of hype with me was they tried to sort of make me like a Mary Poppins at one time, I think, Fox. They took a photograph of me at a photo session, and I had my kind of spiky hair and my big, weird Chinese earrings and my black nail polish or something at the time, and a, you know, my bullet belt, you know. And then I thought, oh, I like that photo session, you know, that was real. And then suddenly I arrive at work one morning and there's a big poster of me outside Fox, but it had been completely doctored. I now had perfectly straight teeth that were like Marine Boy, you know, like, and I had little pearls on my ears and they'd put little sparkly diamondy things in my eyes that glistened. I thought, oh my God, I look retarded.
That I'm seeing at 11 o'clock, Pip.
He's something of a media guru, Mum.
I distrust the word guru. I associate it with these so-called holy men who try to persuade one to sit cross-legged and give away one's worldly goods.
Mr. Jarvis is not that sort of guru, Mum. He's a public relations strategist. I believe the common parlance is spin doctor.
I've heard of spin dryers. Don't they go round and round on dry clothes?
Indeed they do, Mum. Bravo.
I'm much better informed than you think, Pip.
There has been a suggestion from certain quarters, Mum, that the royal family has become somewhat remote from their subjects.
Quite absurd. Whenever there's a national event, we go out and wave at them from our balconies, and they wave back with their little flags and weep.
This is not merely speculation, Mum. This is the opinion of a poll.
A poll? Why would the royal family listen to a poll? I've never even met one. Unless you count that ghastly little Roman Polanski, the original 5-foot pole you wouldn't want to touch anybody with. One loves to garden.
I was referring to an opinion poll, Mum, which showed that young people would prefer the royal family to shed some of their expectations of deference.
I'm not sure I follow you on that one, Peter.
Oh, ladies in waiting, bowing and curtsying, white gloves, you know, that kind of thing.
Good heavens, you'll be doing yourself out of a job if you listen to that nonsense, Pip. We don't want to end up like the Dutch or the Scandinavian royals, do we? They've taken to wearing jeans and riding around the streets on bicycles. And what's the name of the Rainier bunch?
The Grimaldis, Ma'am.
Good Lord, they sound like jugglers. It's no wonder the daughters ended up modelling swimwear.
Your point is taken, Ma'am.
But I do want to be reasonable, Pip, and I understand that times have changed. So you can tell your Dr. Spinperson there are certain things I will not do. I will not go to Canada. I will not wear a kilt. I will not go to sporting events unless they involve horses. And I will under no circumstances have my photograph taken with the Spice Girls. But I am prepared to give up the white gloves.
Very good, Ma. Cancel our 11 o'clock.
Happy gin and tonic, Pip. It's 10:30 already.
Witherspoon Motors, where the 10, the 210, and the 710 meet. So come in and get a deal on a 1999 Ford Aspire you won't believe.
That's right, Al.
And this baby here goes home for nothing. That's right, you heard me. It's free.
Oh, yeah, and the Aunt Durbin don't wear falsies, honey.
It's first prize in our Hands on the Hard Body contest. All you gotta do is keep your hands on this truck longer than any of the other contestants, and you drive this baby home.
Hey.
Come on down to Witherspoon Motors.
There's something Buddy can do. Buddy? Buddy, remain? Get out of bed, it's Friday.
Come on down to
Buddy likes trucks. Hell, he lived in one for 2 years.
I'm doing just fine. It's a beautiful sunny day here. Wilspoon, as you may or may not know, means friendship.
What other components does it have? Yeah. This safety's got everything.
Oh. Got four-wheel drive.
Here we go. Oh, no, 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 Bobby. Bobby, that's good practice, but that's not the right truck, Bobby. Come on. Bobby, there it is over there.
When the saints go marching in.
Everybody, let's get started. Now, these here are the rules. You got to keep one hand on the truck at all times. No leaning. Every hour, there's going to be a five-minute break where you can eat, drink, or relieve yourself, or do all three at the same time if you want to. Okay? Gloves on. Let's go.
Buddy, you got to help me here. Trying to put the three fingers in the one hole. That's up, buddy. Wiggle, wiggle. That's it. Now, listen, son. Nobody does nothing better than you, buddy. Nobody, okay?
Okay, is everybody ready?
Yeah.
All right, hands on.
Let's go here.
Just praise the Lord.
There you go. Now, stay, buddy, stay. Stay, buddy, stay. You know, he once stood in the rice field for 6.5 days with his rifle above his head and 120% humidity, so this is nothing, you know.
Go, Marge, go.
Stay, buddy, stay.
I tell you something that I notice. No country is talking to itself more than America. Oh, yes. I watch the commercials on the TV. It's all the same. It's, hey, America. Wake up, America. What do you want from a truck, America? Other countries, they don't talk to themselves like this. No, no, no. You don't hear, hey, Poland, or hey, what's happening, Slovakia? Of course you do not. And I tell you something else that I don't like about America. On the TV, when I'm watching the Olympics, you see only thing that the American is winning. I am wanting to watch the Romanian pole vault to try for record, and they no show. They show interview with 14-year-old gymnast from Long Beach with broken toe. This I do not like about America. Also, Jell-O salad. Can anyone explain this to me, this Jell-O salad?
All right, we're going into our 12th hour.
5 minute break.
You're doing good, son. Come on, open up. There you go. That's a. Now, you be careful. Don't you get crumbs on our new truck.
Isn't he going to take some time to sit down, ma'am?
Oh, no. It'll just confuse him. Yeah. He watches TV standing up, and I'm not talking half hours. I mean, like, made-for-TV movies, you know? And if it's a two-parter, and it starts on a Monday, he'll stand there till Wednesday, eh? Especially if have the Locklears in it, huh? Like, sir.
Doesn't he ever have to use the restroom?
Oh, no. Oh. See, the diaper that he's wearing is super absorbent. Yeah, we used to use them on Mr. Tony Curtis when we did that movie Trapeze, because we didn't let him down the ladder between takes. I got a seat in my body here. You want another bite? Come on, buddy, keep your strength up. Oh, yeah. That's up. Another big sip for Mommy. That's up.
The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures.
Hey, another one bites the dust. Yeah. See you, loser. Hey. Buddy, suck up. You need your strength. They're dropping like flies, son. You know, buddy, there's a lot of things we can do with a truck. They can hire refrigerators. You can sell lobsters up on Milhoan. Oh, yeah. And you can help the police haul Mexicans back home. Hey, buddy, while you're south of the border, you can pick up some of those hard-on pills that all those horny lawyers and agents in Beverly Hills can't get enough of, yeah? Oh, she's up. See there? Oh, honest, I thought she'd go the distance to a young girl like that. Hey, buddy. Stay. It's going good, son.
The after-death market is very overhyped here in Florida. Well, it's because of the demographics. You know the saying, one foot on the beach is one foot in the grave. Ugh, we're all barraged with handbills, phone calls, TV spots. They catch you right after reruns of Touched by an Angel, the bastards. Which is why I've wound up with three caskets that I've had to bring up from the basement because of termites. This little rosewood number with satin lining we got as a special deal with a timeshare vacation condo. You see the inside? The master bedroom of that joint was less roomy. This little plywood painted to look like ebony number I nearly sold to Mrs. O'Malley in 1B. They never let the Irish above the first floor. But her new liver took, so she bought a treadmill instead. But at least I found a good use for one of them. I can't stay out in the sun for long. I have skin like a baby. Ugh, gotta put on my SPF 75.
Hour 64, day 3. Three people
you,
still
pal.
Standing.
One of the truckless. Okay, buddy. There's two others left, and here's the skinny. I don't think that this young fella's gonna last long, because I heard him tell his wife that he's numb from the pelvis on down. But the Virgin Mary, she's still going strong. Even singing those hymns for 2 days now. Jesus H. Christ, down the crutch, could you hold her down? She's out! She's out! I think I've earned myself a little nap, okay? Mm-hmm. Oh, Jesus, Mary and Joseph. Uncle Chef, what the hell are you doing here?
Well, I was traveling through the state looking for some fruit picking work when I heard on the radio that a certain buddy Romaine was about to win a truck. I'm so proud of our boy.
He's not our boy. He's my boy.
He's my boy, too. Or are you forgetting that hot afternoon we spent down by the swamp?
Hey! You told me never to tell anybody. I told Ma I was nursing a child for the county.
Well, you got to admit that I treated Buddy like one of my own and took him on that fishing trip.
Yeah, and then you went boozing with your friends and you left the poor little Mike there.
Well?
You are as bad a father to him as you were an uncle to me.
Well, I'm here now to make up for it.
No, you
hey, Buddy.
Don't.
It's your daddy. Hey, buddy boy, do you remember me giving you this chewy backy when you were little? Made all your little baby teeth turn brown? Jump one. Put hairs on your chest.
No, don't eat that, buddy. It's not good for you. See what your mama's got, huh? Look, buddy. Got a nice fresh ding-dong for you. Come on, son, open up. Eat some of this.
I'm going to sit here and wait, buddy, so I can be the first one to congratulate you when you win this truck. And then your daddy and your great uncle, both of them being me, is gonna take you fishing.
And I'm gonna sit here and see that you don't. Hey, don't you start with your meddling. You'll stay away from him. It's the first time he's seen you in 50 years. Stop chuckling. Oh, I'm watching you. I'm watching you good. Oh, fall asleep, huh?
Ruby! Ruby, wake up! Come on, Ruby! Ruby, wake up! Come on!
What? Who needs me on the cell? Tell that bitch Maureen O'Hara she's got enough blush on.
Ruby, come on. Everybody's gone. It's time to go home. Come on. Here we go.
Jesus.
Come on.
What happened?
Let me help you. There you go. Well, the last person fainted in the 76 hour after you ate a bacon and bean burrito.
Oh.
Your son won.
Hey! Oh, my goodness. Why didn't you wake me?
Well, we tried. Threw ice on you and everything. You just out to the world over there.
Where's my champ, buddy? Buddy!
Hey, Ruby.
Buddy, what?
Being that your boy's kind of slow and all, we registered the truck in his daddy's name, and they took off together.
Oh, hell. Oh, hell, El. What are you going to do that for?
What'd I do?
Oh, Jesus. Jesus. You don't have to tell me what's going on, buddy. I can guess. Your Uncle Daddy went to get bait, right? Well, don't be surprised if it takes him another 50 years to bring it back. Jeez. Come on in, buddy. We'll open that can of Anderson's pea soup I've been saving. You did real good, son. You did real good. You're a winner. Hey, buddy, I'm not a truck. Come on.
This new terminal is shit. We done had a partner inconvenience sign up for 2.5 years now.
Shanisha.
What?
Help me with this damn thing.
No, bitch, I ain't ruining my manicure.
Remember when those design people had us staying late to watch that video? Got us all hyped up about how we was gonna be taking passengers into the 21st century. Shit, we can't even take them to the sunglass hut. Cause that people mover's not moving nobody's ass.
Again.
It's that bitch with them flip-flops.
And those new automatic toilets, they sounded good on paper, but in reality, I don't want no goddamn sewer system telling me when to flush.
I know that's right.
I made a false move this morning, and my butt got holes good.
You had the wet ass?
I had the wet ass.
Well, one good thing did come out of this.
What's that?
Remember that nun used to come around here with the popcorn bucket, begging for money?
Mm-hmm.
She don't come around here no more. She ain't taking this shit.
She won't take this shit.
We shouldn't take this shit. Okay, we should get a new job.
Come on.
So sorry,
Linda. You know Bev Tillis, Warner Brothers Publicity.
I see you again, Bev. Nice to meet you. I'm sure you know why you're here. I'm sure Candy told you. We're about to release VIP Lounge, the movie, and we would really like your help in promoting it.
My help?
I already told Bev that we were pretty unhappy when they announced they were going to do a movie of your TV series without you.
Mm-hmm. I cried that night, Bev. I don't mind telling you, but I woke up the next morning, and I sent Cindy Crawford a note, well, a notelet, wishing her love, luck, and lollipops, and it came from the heart, Bev. It really did.
Okay. All right. I think the first thing that we should do is get you some in-depth interviews in the gay press.
That shouldn't be too hard. Gays are crazy about her. Have you seen that gay Hollywood Halloween parade? Every other guy is dressed as Linda.
Oh, but a word of advice, Bev. Don't get involved in the costume judging. Remember that Sharon Oscar night spit on me, Candy?
Faggot.
Candy, please.
Well, I don't care. He spit on you.
Okay. Now, what I want you to do is I want you to play the martyr. You're very upset. You weren't included in the movie. And then I want you to badmouth Cindy Crawford a little.
Now, I know that sounds crazy, kid, but Bev tells me it's a campaign that's worked with these TV to movie things.
Absolutely. It's called reverse marketing. I mean, everybody's doing it. Peter Lupus did it for Mission Impossible, and then Jan and Greg did it for both of the Brady Bunch movies and the big hits.
I don't think I'd be convincing, because I can't think of anything bad to say about Cindy Crawford.
Try.
She's so marvelous.
Well, it's no problem, because you know what? My staff will make up some negative things, we'll feed that to the press, and then we'll attribute them to you.
I don't know, though.
How about you sang the theme song to the movie, and it would be a music video, huh?
Mm-hmm. Oh, my. What, Candy, I'd be on MTV?
Absolutely.
Oh, my goodness.
Well, I don't know about MTV, but I think I could get you some placement on VH1.
Oh, the Michael Bolton channel. Yeah. Oh, I love it on a rainy day. Mm-hmm. Oh, I don't know if I'm supposed to do this bitter, unhappy, jealous thing. It's going to take some rehearsal.
Okay, try. Mm-hmm.
What, like,
Say something.
No. Oh. God, I'm so mad at Cindy Crawford.
Oh, not really. I think she's marvelous. You see, I'm apologizing. It's going to take some rehearsal.
All right.
It didn't come naturally. It didn't trip off the tongue there.
Welcome back. We're talking today with Linda Granger, the original star of TV's VIP Lounge. Linda, are you okay?
I'm sorry, Leeza, but I am just so hurt.
Well, your story of show business betrayal has gotten a lot of coverage, especially in the gay press.
Yes, they are.
We're here. We're queer. We're really mad that Linda's not in the movie. Get used to it.
Oh, thank you so much. Candy kisses. Oh, you're so wonderful. But there is some good news, because I have just released the single and a video from the movie Danger in Disguise.
But now, I actually thought that Celine Dion did the title song for the movie.
Well, darling, that's right. She did the ballad. I do the disco remix, so.
Back to your feud with Cindy.
Yeah.
I would like to read from your actual press release now, and I'm quoting here.
Yes, please.
Cindy Crawford is a no-talent slut.
Ooh.
Oh, Linda?
Goodness, I was so angry at the time, you know,
You go on to say, Miss Crawford couldn't act her way out of a bulimia clinic, which I'm sure she attends.
Did I say that?
And not only that, if she's half as bad in bed as she is on the big screen, then I can see why
Cindy... Oh, no, Leeza, don't.
I'm sorry, Bev, I can't keep up this charade. No. Who is Bev?
Beth Mellis is the PR woman for the movie. And I know she thinks that these hateful remarks are brilliant headline grabbers, but I can't go through with it. I have to say that I think that Cindy Crawford is a marvelous actress, and I think she's a gifted spokesperson. I don't care if they yank my video. I just have to say that.
But Linda.
Thank you.
No, you shouldn't be upset. No. You must come back, because what this means to me is, in this age of sleep, come over here so we can applaud you for your courage to be so kind. So kind.
What a wonderful way of putting it, Leeza. You're so wonderful. You are so wonderful. Your skin is beautiful.
Well, and not only that, thank you, but they may not show your video after this. But you know what, Leeza? We're going to show it. We're going to show it right here, right now. The video.
Sometimes you get little man, always flying, always trying to be bigger, better. Something.
Boys I used in my Vegas act.
They're marvelous, aren't they? Very funky, fresh. That's the term they use now, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
fresh.
Trace.
Good night, Trace. Good night, Trace.
Good night,
Trace.
Go home. Go home.
Go home.